get filled.
Look at these high heels.
Is that one?
Yeah.
I would take a picture of those shoes. You bet.
Doing a video.
I like the glasses.
My baby face.
That was Aaron.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of family and friends to join Ashleigh and Kyle in holy matrimony, which is commended to be honorable among mankind. and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and solemnly. Into this holy estate, Ashleigh and Kyle now come to be joined. Friends, we are here to share a very important day in the lives of Ashleigh and Kyle, their wedding day. We are honored to be a part of this day, to witness their vows and send them off as husband and wife with love and blessings. Ashleigh and Kyle have brought us together here for an occasion of great joy and a cause for great celebration. Having found each other, they have built the kind of relationship that will serve them well as a foundation for their marriage. They have chosen each and every one of you to be here with them to witness their wedding vows as they join together in marriage. Each of us knows that a marriage is not created by law or ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the hearts of two human beings. It grows out of loving, caring, and sharing ourselves with one another. And so it is that Ashleigh and Kyle have connected their hearts and souls, one to the other, drawing upon the depths of their being, the need to live united, loving, and complete. Today they have come before us to publicly affirm their love. They do so knowing that marriage is the most tender yet challenging of all relations in life. And so we have gathered here as family and friends to witness and celebrate with them as they enter into the sacred and joyous covenant of marriage. Who presents this woman to be married to this man? Let us pray. Dear God, the source of all love, please be present today during this sacred ceremony. We especially ask your blessing on this couple who stand before us and for all who are gathered to share their joy. May your love encircle Ashleigh and Kyle during this service, and may their marriage be richly filled with the love and joy only you can bring. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love, they may honor the promises they make this day through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. You may be seated. And now, Kyle, do you take Ashleigh for your lawful wedded wife to live in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, honor, comfort, and cherish her from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her for as long as you both shall live? And Ashleigh, do you take Kyle for your lawful wedded husband to live in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, honor, comfort, and cherish him from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him as long as you both shall live? Ashleigh and Kyle, we are here to share your wedding day, one of the most important days of your life, as we witness your vows and share in your joy. When you leave here today, you will be husband and wife, launching into your future together. From now on, your thoughts and concerns will be shared. Your lives will be intertwined as one. No longer will you think only about your personal needs, but instead you will think about each other, concerned about each other's needs, plans, and goals. You will identify with each other, feel part of each other, even more so than you have in these past years of dating. We are here today for your wedding, but this is not a marriage. What makes a marriage is what comes next. What makes a marriage is what you do tomorrow and the next day and the following weeks, months, and years. Marriage is a gift, the gift of yourself, of your life every day from here forward. You must continue to give yourselves to one another. That makes a marriage. It means putting your spouse's interests, their wants, and desires ahead of your own. It means letting go of petty fights about who is right and who is wrong. It means remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It means having the capacity to forgive and forget. It means giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow individually and together. It means not only marrying the right partner, but also being the right partner. This is precisely what Jesus meant when he told us to love one another. And it's what Paul meant when he wrote that we should be clothed in love. That is what it means to become one flesh, forever joined together. You are each your wedding gift to one another, and your marriage is a gift of continuing to give yourselves to one another. It must be both of you, and it must be a decision you make every day. In marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life, created, ordered, and blessed by God. Today we are gathered with you to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to surround you with our prayers, and to ask God's blessing upon you, so that you may be strengthened for your life together and nurtured in your love of your marriage by declaring your vows to one another here in the presence of God, your family, and friends. I'll repeat after me. I, Kyle, take you, Ashleigh, to be my wife, and I promise before God and these witnesses to to be your loving and faithful husband. In plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Ashleigh, repeat. I, Ashleigh, take you kind.
Take you kind.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And I promise.
And I promise.
Before God and his witnesses.
Before God and his witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
Joy and sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live. What do you bring as a sign of your promise? Let us pray. By your blessing, O God, may these rings be to Ashleigh and Kyle symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the covenant they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Ring I give you as a sign of our constant faith and abiding hope. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you
as a sign of our constant faith.
A sign of our constant faith
and abiding hope. Ashleigh and Kyle, you have just sealed your relationship by the giving and receiving of rings. This covenant is a relationship pledge between two people who agree that they will share the rest of their lives with each other. Now, as a symbol of this relationship, you will pour the two individual containers of sand, the pink one representing Ashleigh and all that she is and ever will be, and the silver one representing Kyle and all that he is and ever will be. As these two containers are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage be. Please bow in prayer. Eternal God, without your grace, no promise is sure. Strengthen Kyle and Ashleigh with patience, kindness, gentleness, and all the other gifts of your Spirit, so that they may fulfill the vows they have made. Keep them faithful to each other and to you. Fill them with such love and joy that they may build a home of peace and welcome. Guide them by your word to serve you all their days. Grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their lives strengthened, and that all who are married may depart with their own promises renewed. With our love and with the Spirit's blessing, we offer our prayers for Kyle and Ashleigh on this, their wedding day, and throughout their journey together as partners in marriage.
Time.
all gathered here, Kyle and Ashleigh have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of ring. May you keep this covenant you have made. May you bless each other in your marriage, comforting each other when one needs comfort and sharing each other's joys, helping each other in all your endeavors throughout your married life together. I now proclaim that you are husband and wife. Blessed be the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, whom God has joined together. Let no one set asunder.
Thank you.